Hey, welcome back to your Caribou Data Science channel. Today is, well, what is today? Today is Wednesday, July the 6th, 2021. And of course, it's that time of day we go back and we'd update a few databases and so forth. You know the drill. We began, of course, as always, by run a package update. That's good news. And then we come over here to the shell. Go back up one directory. Pull down the John Hopkins data. Okay, let's do this then. Let's do, my mind's beginning to waver. And as always, I'll just remind you that the New York Times data set is a U.S. state and county level data set, while the John Hopkins, I believe, is worldwide. It's also a cumulative total, as is New York Times cumulative totals. So in order to use either John Hopkins or New York Times, we have to use a script, which you'll see in a moment, which splits the COVID-19 data out by days. So you have data, rather than cumulative cases and cumulative deaths, you have daily cases and daily deaths, both the John Hopkins University data set and New York Times. And that's what these scripts are here for. They're the ones that split out the data. Okay? They're the ones that split out the data. Then after that's done, So. This is a script I did to actually connect R to a Microsoft SQL server on my, okay? The next objective is to do the same script for Oracle. Okay, you can see it over here. Let's just try this. It should be similar to, you know, it should be similar. Okay. Driver should change, and this should change. Database, trusted connection, yes. I don't know. Here's an interesting question. Since we do have OBDC here, I believe my That'll be worth taking a look at a little bit. Okay, so let's go back over here. Let's run the New York Times data set now. Okay, we're getting close here. Okay, let's just check and make sure the databases did update correctly. That one did. And that one does. Okay. So that concludes the database update portion of our report. Today we'll be back in a moment or two with the latest COVID-19 update for your country.